Good morning students, in the last part of the chapter, the food factory of plants, we learned about the functions of a leaf and how a leaf is the most important part of a plant. And in today's session, we are going to learn about some unusual plants. And in order to do that, first of all, we all have to open our books on page number 18. And now you have to repeat after me. There are many other plants that are different from green plants because of their unusual features. So unusual plants are different from green plants because they have some different features or unusual features. Let us learn more about such unusual plants. So first of all, we are going to learn about non-green plants. Non-green plants. There are certain non-green plants that do not have chlorophyll. So some plants are non-green as they do not have chlorophyll. They do not have chlorophyll. And we have learned that chlorophyll is very important for the process of photosynthesis for a plant to prepare its food. So if they don't have chlorophyll, they cannot prepare their own food. Thus, these plants cannot prepare their own food. So they do not have chlorophyll and they cannot prepare their own food. These plants depend on dead and decaying plants and animals for food. So if they cannot make their own food, they have to eat something. So they feed on or they depend on plants and animals that are dead and decaying for their food. So they feed on dead and decaying plants and animals. From where do these non-green plants get food? Now, from where do they get food? How do they feed themselves? They get or absorb food from other sources such as soil and green plants. So they absorb food from soil or they get it from other plants. Mushrooms and bracket fungi are some examples of non-green plants that are commonly found around us. We can see mushroom here. So mushroom takes or absorbs food from the soil and bracket fungi gets the food from the tree branches. So the examples are mushroom and bracket fungi. Mushrooms have very thin and root-like structures that go deep into the soil. These structures help them to absorb food from the soil. So just like roots absorb nutrients from the soil, mushrooms also absorb nutrients from the soil. Bracket fungi grow on tree trunks. Bracket fungi looks like soft bread or cottage cheese and it grows on tree trunks. They absorb food from the trees. Now we are going to learn about insectivorous plants. Some plants attract, capture, kill and digest insects. Such plants are known as insectivorous plants or carnivorous plants. So the insectivorous plants, they attract, capture, kill and digest insects. They are also called carnivorous plants. Now because they feed only on insects and not on anything like plants, they are called insectivorous plants or carnivorous plants. Venus flytraps, sundew and pitcher plant are some examples of insectivorous plants. So some examples are Venus flytrap, sundew plant and pitcher plant. Now here it is given how a pitcher plant eats. In a pitcher plant, the leaf is shaped like a pitcher with a small lid. The pitcher is brightly colored to attract insects. Here we can see that it is shaped like a pitcher with a small lid. And it has bright colors. It has some red colors and bright green color. So it is very colorful so as to attract insects. When an insect enters the pitcher, it slips and falls into the juice below the pitcher. So, when an insect comes and sits on the pitcher plant, it falls and it slips. And it goes inside this pitcher and there is juice, digestive juices in the pitcher plant. This traps the insect inside. Digestive juices inside the pitcher digest the insect. So, after the insect slips and falls into the pitcher, there are some digestive juices inside it and so it digests the insects. That is all for today. Thank you.